morning, we are in Marrakesh. We have had an early start because we need to go on this bike adventure. So we had to quickly grab some breakfast and we found these typical buns that they do here. And we found some juice, packed juice. But at least we're ready in time and we're waiting for our pickup and off to our bike adventure. So update time, situation has changed. We are not going on a bike ride because their group was a little bit disorganized. I'm not sure precisely the details, but apparently it's full. Not sure why they booked this in and arranged everything if it was full. But anyway, so we are now resuming our sightseeing of Marrakesh, which still works. And it's now a sunny day. So we are gonna see this 12th century mosque with garden, which is literally over here. The most impressive thing once again here in Morocco, and it is these are not any palm trees, they are aerials for your mobile phone. And literally they are fake palm trees and they even have dates hanging from them, and these are huge, these are very big, and two of them for some reason right next to each other, a big one and a little one. Money just got the most weird juice ever, avocado and mango. It's yummy, definitely not what I was gonna expect, but I like it. Good job, Money. Here and has managed to upcycle tyres. Check this out.
All made by tyres. Even like little bowls from tyres.
They don't necessarily try to go big or huge over the top, they just go ornate and create nice little spaces. Like, check out the ceiling here. All made out of wood, nice painted, nice light. Definitely focus on the stone. What do you think about it so far, Moni?
I think it's incredible. Everything's handmade, very intricate.
Yeah.
Very impressive.
Yeah, a lot of skilled labour. Apparently they came from Fez. See?
Yes.
Yes. Must have finished. Skilled people in Morocco? Marrakesh? Oh,
so they brought very them talented Fez citizens.
Very talented Fez people. Courtyard after courtyard after courtyard after mosaic after mosaic. So One day, we'll get to you. Showed you there came from this room here, and it's quite cute to have a look at. Put your head in through the arch and have a look at the mosaics and whatever they are. The tombs, that's what it is, because we're in this space where they found some tombs and they have built this space around it. That's the train station, money. This is really interesting. We're out of the old part of town now, and we are, but it looks a bit more modern. A lot more traffic, bigger roads, taller buildings. More like what I was expecting Marrakesh to be like, to be honest. But it's very interesting working around, like the big graffitis as well. We have succeeded. We have got 2 tickets. The amount of Googling that we had to do to find out how you buy these bus tickets, sending us to different websites to see if you can buy them there. But anyway, in the end, we managed to find the place, which is next to the train station. Not super next to it, but we managed to find it. And we've got 2 first class tickets on a coach tomorrow to Essa Oria, which is the beach place that we're gonna go tomorrow. So we got our tickets, place is reserved, and we need to be here tomorrow, same 9 o'clock. We are still driving around Newtown. Skybar in Marrakesh, and we are just seeing what is happening downstairs. Basically, there's a concert happening in the main square, and there's all these kind of crowd control systems. They had metal detectors as well to stop people coming in, and now there's like a line of security. There they are. They've created like a human barrier. I think they're only letting people out and not in. That's why down there looks pretty empty. Well, here it's pretty crowded. It's a man-made fence. So we are walking home, and this is another really interesting thing that you find in Morocco. Literally, on the go, petrol stations. Literally, as simple as that. DIY.